Glencairn Museum was built between 1928 and 1939 by craftspeople who were hired by Raymond and Mildred Pitcairn to build their home. Glencairn looks like a castle, but it was their private residence for Raymond and Mildred Pitcairn and their children. Today, as a museum, we have art and artifacts from religions from around the world and across time. Today, we're going to be talking about the life of medieval Europe. When I talk about medieval Europe or the Middle Ages, I'm talking about a time frame between 500 and 1500 CE. Historians who study this time often divide the people who lived then into different categories. Three categories: those who prayed, those who worked, and those who fought. These three groups had a lot in common and a lot that was different. What they had in common was that they lived in the same area, medieval Europe, and they also shared the same faith, Christianity or Catholicism. The differences that they had came from the groups that they were born into, the groups of society that they were born into. Some people were born into tremendous wealth and lived life of privilege and safety. Others were born into poverty and struggled to get food for themselves and their families. So for some, life was easier, and for others, life was harder for reasons that were rarely fair. We're going to start by looking at this bench behind me. Right behind me, we have a dark wood choir stall. It comes from Spain, probably around the 16th century, sometime in the 1500s. This choir stall was used by monks when they were at prayer. The word monk comes from the Greek, a Greek word that means single or alone. Monks were men who in the Middle Ages removed themselves from the busy hustle and bustle of life and lived separately from that busy world so that they could devote their lives to praying to God. The choir stall behind me was probably used by them over hundreds of years ago. It was used in the monastery by monks for prayer. One thing about this bench that I think is really cool is right here and right here, there are hinged seats that could fold down when the monks had to pray seated for long periods of time. But there were also times when they had to stand, so these same seats fold up. It's also decorated with rich carvings. On either side of me here, we see two monks, and they're busy at work. And this is where dividing people into categories gets a little complicated, because both monks and nuns who lived in monasteries and abbeys were people who prayed, but also people who worked. On this side, we see a monk who's busy reading the Gospels. Monks would spend a lot of time reading and studying the Bible. And on this side, we see a monk who's busy writing. In the early Middle Ages, it was the jobs of monks and nuns to serve as scribes, and they spent a lot of time copying religious works. Now, these weren't the only two things that monks and nuns would have to do. There were lots of other things they had to do as work instead of just praying. They would have to do everything that went into running the monastery or the abbey. That included growing the food, taking care of the animals, creating other beautiful works of art, and also taking care of and learning about medicine, because people would come to the abbeys and monasteries to be healed. So it was important that they knew about that. There are other carvings on this bench. On this side, we see one of the hinged seats in the folded up position, and there's an image of a shell on it. The shell became a symbol for medieval pilgrimage. Pilgrimage is a word that means holy journey. Many people in the Middle Ages took these journeys, and many people across many religions and great periods of time also take these holy journeys. They still happen today. Another carving we see here is the image of a monkey. The monkey is clutching a cluster of grapes to his belly, and there's a chain around his waist. When a monk would look at this image of this monkey, it would remind him not to fall into the temptation of greed, to not to want more, not to take more than he needed, but to be kinder and not as greedy. On this side, there's a figure with a crown holding a harp. This is very likely an image of King David. King David, who is known for writing the Psalms in the Bible. So a monk sitting at this bench, looking at that image of King David, would be reminded of those beautiful songs, reminded that they come from David as they sang them or recited them. So all these symbols that are throughout this bench and all the details were reminders to the monks who sat here, who prayed here. It was a reminder to them to be good and kind and to live a life according to the teachings of their faith. So thank you for joining me as we took this virtual trip through the Middle Ages and learning about the life of people who lived them, especially about monks and nuns. If you'd like to know about more people, I encourage you to watch other videos in this series. We have videos on the life of a scribe, of a knight, and of a stonemason. And if you'd like to learn more about Glencairn Museum, I encourage you to visit our website, glencairnmuseum.org.